President Trump wrapping his speech up at the Cobb Galleria Center just minutes ago. His message, getting more African Americans to vote Republican in Georgia.
CBS 46 political analyst Rashad Ritchie joining us now with his reaction to the president's trip to Atlanta and his push, Rashad, to get African Americans to vote for him. You know, he has said over and over that no president, with the exception perhaps of Abraham Lincoln, has done more for African Americans than he has. What do you make of that?
Well, the vast majority of black voters who were polled after that statement disagreed with the president. It is interesting that he's coming to the state of Georgia, which historically is a red state, a Republican state, when he should be spending time in swing states. This is a difference in the campaign. Remember, in 2016, Donald Trump won the state of Georgia with 51% of the vote. A poll was released this week, Rick, that shows Biden and Trump at 47% each. I've been an analyst for a long time. This may be the best gamble for the Trump campaign, going after black voters. And here's why. He has reached what we call market saturation with every other demographic in the state of Georgia. He's not increasing his white male or white female demographic. His Latino demographic is pretty steady. He's looking to increase his vote total of 8% of the African-American vote to roughly 10 to 12% in order to inch out a victory.
Rashad, it's interesting you mentioned that because the presidential race is neck and neck. It could go either way. What are President Trump's chances of luring black voters to vote for him?
Yeah, like my grandmother used to say, nothing beats a failure but a try, and a try this is, right? But we're not hearing the policy issues at the forefront. The vast majority of voters, Democrat, Republican, Independent, black, white, brown, male, female, are already decided. Only 6% of voters in Georgia say they are undecided. So he has a very small pool to actually recruit from. So while, yes, the attempt is part of a campaign promise and obligation, it seems as if the pool to recruit from is smaller than it has been historically.
All right, Dr. Rashad Ritchie, your insight always invaluable to us. We appreciate your comments tonight.
Thanks, Rashad.